Home to three major rivers, once the center of our state's railroad industry, and a legend of John Henry. I'm Wayne Worth, and you're watching On the Road in West Virginia, R55 County's Summers County. Long before locomotives rolled through the county, it was said that some of the first European explorers, mainly the Batts and Phalum expedition, walked these hills during the late 1600s. Now, having three majestic rivers, the Greenbrier, Bluestone, and New, meander through and intersect of what we today call Summers County, would be considered prime real estate for a white settler during the 1700s, as rivers were the interstate highways of the 18th century. However, it also meant that your not-so-friendly neighbors who were native to this great land also had a stake in this territory, and they would do what it took to make sure that no person of European descent, especially English, would settle this region. Well, the early white settlers gave it a scout's try during the 1750s and 1760s and found out by way of tomahawk to the head that this wasn't going to work. Or at least it wasn't going to work during the French and Indian War and at the height of Pontiac's Rebellion. By the Revolutionary War, though, when most of the natives were tired of fighting and the French were on our side, peaceful settlement resumed in the region. Now, things were pretty slow going here during much of the 19th century, as much of what we today call Summers County existed through self-sustaining agriculture. However, that would all change with the American Civil War and the Industrial Revolution that followed. The Civil War didn't bring any major battles to the county, as much of the area was very rugged and hard to navigate. However, there were small skirmishes which took place mainly due to the county being a hotbed for Confederate sympathizers and bushwhackers, and of course your occasional Union troop movements didn't help matters either. Probably one of the most notable events during the Civil War in Summers County, other than the Confederates' attempt to overtake Union forces at Pack's Ferry, was the passing through of Lieutenant Colonel Rutherford B. Hayes, you know, this dude who would later become our 19th president. Now, real change came to Summers County after the Civil War with the construction of the C&O Railroad and the dawn of the coal boom in southern West Virginia. To put this into perspective, the county's population doubled between 1880 and 1920, and the town of Hinton, which was purchased by the C&O Railroad in 1871, went from only having six families living there to having a population of around 3,700 by the year 1900. The C&O even built a roundhouse and a rail car shop because steam locomotives always required maintenance. This addition to the terminal in Hinton didn't only create 500 more jobs, but also helped the population of the town exceed over 6,500 residents by 1930. Hotels, stores, taverns, entertainment venues started popping up out of nowhere. Even the streets were made of brick and beautiful two-story homes and commercial structures were built. When the town was incorporated in 1880, it was even deemed a county seat. As a result, Hinton overnight became a major center of our state's railroad industry. Now, the railroad may have brought a lot of prosperity to the county, but it also brought the legend of this steel-driving man. The construction of the Great Bend Tunnel between 1870 and 1872 would test not only the strength of a man, but also put to the test some of the new railroad building technology. This is also where the legend of John Henry was born. Now, it's said that a contractor for Great Bend hoped to replace the railroad workers with a steam-powered steel-driving and drilling machine. So a contest was organized between the steel-driving machine and the best steel-driving man in the crew to see if any man could produce better results. Old John Henry accepted the challenge and, to everyone's surprise, outperformed the machine. Unfortunately for John, this would be the first and last contest in outperforming any machine, because legend has it at the end of the race he fell dead from overexertion. Sadly, the building of the Great Bend Tunnel would also take the lives of many other workers, mainly due to foul air and frequent cave-ins. Now, the 1950s and 1960s would bring tough economic times to Hinton, as diesel would replace steam. To make a long story short, trains powered by diesel instead of steam meant the end of a boom in Hinton, as diesel-powered engines required far less maintenance. As a result, the town's population went from around 5,700 in 1950 to around 2,500 today. Though the good old days of the mighty C&O are long gone, one could still go to the Hinton Railroad Museum and go back in time and learn about an industry which built this county and helped expand our great nation. Now, after a sharp decline in the railroad industry, Summers County would make significant strides over the years to diversify their economy, and they would do that through tourism. hey, when you have three of the most beautiful rivers in our state, you make the most of the treasures that you have, and Summers County has definitely done that. Of course, it didn't come without a little help from our friend President Franklin Roosevelt, who in 1935 issued an executive order for the construction of the Bluestone Dam. 3 years after its completion in 1952, Bluestone State Park was introduced in the West Virginia park system and provides vast recreational opportunities to visitors near and far. Of course, the most notable river in the county is the New River, and by no means is it new. Now it got its name from the early white explorers when they first discovered the river, and since it was new to them, they just named it the New River. Matter of fact, it's one of the oldest rivers on our planet, and today one of the most recreationally used rivers on the East Coast, which we'll talk more about when we visit Fayette County. Just down the road a piece is one of our state's most treasured parks. Since 1970, Pipestem State Park has not only been one of West Virginia's premier state parks, but has also been a stabilizing force in the county's economy. Now with two golf courses, cross-country skiing, and of course my favorite, a 3,600-foot-long aerial tramway, the park easily attracts over 1 million visitors every year. 17th century explorers, two wars, a railroad, and John Henry. Summers County has seen it all, but not like this river, which has seen everything. I'm Wayne Worth, and until next time, always remember, what we value and hold important to our lives today came from events that happened yesterday, and it's when we begin to understand the events of yesterday that we fully embrace today, which makes tomorrow become less of a mystery.